I do not feel safe. Mask mandate backlash in Kansas town prompts mayor to resign. We also have this story from Reason. Americans are in full revolt against pandemic lockdowns. And then we saw in California, maskless mob storms gourmet grocery in city awash with death. Well, of course, the Daily Beast is a more left-leaning publication, but the story is true. A group of people who were angry at lockdown orders and restrictions and edict stormed their way into a shop and said, "We want to shop." Maybe you've seen the videos that have come out. A woman beating a sheriff with the sheriff's baton after being ordered to wear a mask. A report that a Navy veteran bashed a man over the head with a glass for being told to wear a mask. Now, the mask thing I find kind of weird. You know, people complaining about not having to wear a mask. I get it. People don't want to wear it. I see these people yelling, "Don't wear it." I don't mind wearing a mask. It's not that big of a deal. Where at least, you know, when you're going around, you're walking around, you're by yourself, you don't need one. It's when you're in close proximity to people or you're going to a store. I'm not all that worried about it. What I am worried about is that the lockdowns are destroying everything and it's leading to this kind of rage, this pent-up anger that's going to be way worse than anything we've seen so far. The George Floyd riots were intense, weren't they? Well, many people said the reason people were so angry wasn't just the social justice. It was that they were locked in a cubicle for months. They couldn't go out. They couldn't see their friends. And they were filled with rage, no purpose, depression. There are stories of young people, children, committing suicide. And it's increased and it's horrifying. People are starting to reach their breaking point. And it's gotten so bad that a small town mayor had to actually resign because people have said enough. Well, as Reason puts it, people across this country are revolting or in open revolt against these lockdowns. It doesn't mean every single person. It means enough people are saying no. And I'll tell you this, if everybody just said no, if everybody just went back to work, there would be no lockdown and no one could do anything about it. But now we're getting some grim news. Super COVID. I'm not kidding. They're calling it super COVID. They're saying in California and in Colorado, they detected traces of a new variant, which is substantially more infectious. Now, don't get me wrong, my friends. I think COVID's very serious, and I've long stated this. The issue, though, is serious doesn't mean like it's airborne Ebola that's going to wipe everybody out. It means it mostly affects people with comorbidities, you know, people above the age of 70. And that for those reasons, we should be taking it seriously. We should be working on vaccines. Donald Trump is the one who pushed for warp speed to get these vaccines out. And so I think a lot of people, you know, it's really interesting. I did a Twitter poll. Have you gotten the vaccine yet? And these leftists seem to think that everybody who watches my content are anti-vaxxers. Now, there are a lot of people who are saying they're going to wait. Kamala Harris said she'd wait, and she went and got it. But most people are like, this was Trump's project. This is Project Warp Speed. Trump did it. Why are Trump supporters supposed to act like they're now not interested in it? Don't get me wrong. There are a lot of people who support Trump who are saying they're not going to get this vaccine. But I think it's fair to point out there's a big difference between long-standing vaccines that have gone through decades of trial and something that was rushed out the door. That's what Biden and Kamala Harris and other Democrats had been saying. Now, look, you got to do your own research and talk to your doctor about what's right for you. But we're hearing that the super COVID is going to be grounds to keep these lockdowns indefinitely. We're hearing that in California, where these people are storming into these buildings, the lockdown is, for now, an indefinite lockdown. There's no timeline. There's no light at the end of the tunnel. There's no point at which you know you will be free when you can work, when you can feed your family. And worse still, from the establishment elites, namely the Republicans right now, you are not getting the COVID relief you need. Trump and Bernie together are mad about this. So I find it really fascinating. Who are these establishment cronies who would lock everything down and then have, you know, the other faction, the Democrats, lock it down, and then Republicans block the 2K just so that regular people can suffer? This clearly isn't working, and people are going to erupt, and they already are. Well, let's start. Let's read about what happened in this small town, because when it starts here, you know, it starts to spread. How long until New York erupts completely into large-scale rioting like we saw with George Floyd? Before we get started, head over to timcast.com/donate. If you'd like to support my work, there are many ways you can give. I got a P.O. box. You want to send me some stuff. Got some crypto addresses. But the best thing you can do is share this video. Let people know what's going on. If you think I'm doing a good job and what I have to say is important, sharing really does help my channel survive and grow. Because as you can probably imagine, I'm not a preferred YouTube channel for the most part. I know YouTube does like me to a certain degree, but only insofar as they have to tolerate politics. But sharing, that's power. Get more people exposed to more information. But don't forget, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Let's read the story from Kansas City Star. Quote, I do not feel safe. Mask mandate backlash in Kansas town prompts mayor to resign. The mayor of a historic western Kansas town resigned amid backlash over a mask mandate and national attention on COVID-19 in the community. Dodge City Mayor Joyce Warshaw stepped down Tuesday. She cited fears for her safety and a hope that her resignation could quell anger. Life has dealt out many challenges in our world that have perhaps caused many people to act inappropriately. But I do not feel safe in this position anymore, and am hopeful in removing myself, I'm assuming they mean from, this anger. Accusations and abuse will not fall on anyone else and will calm down, Warshaw wrote. Warshaw told the Dodge City Globe she received threats in emails and phone calls after a USA Today article on December 11th about residents failing to comply with a mask mandate as COVID-19 cases surged. The mask mandate was imposed a month ago. Warshaw was quoted once in the story, quote, we just felt like we had to do something so everybody was aware of how important it was for everybody to be responsible for each other's health and well-being, she told the USA Today. Oh, hold on. We felt we had to do something so everyone was aware? Are you saying that that you didn't tell them to wear the masks for safety reasons? That's a stupid thing to say. So no, it's no surprise people had a backlash, that there was a backlash to this. You need to tell them wearing a mask so you don't spit on people when you talk. It's really that simple. Now, there's questions about asymptomatic spread and things like this, so I understand why people are finally starting to lose it. Trust in the media is gone. And if there's no trust in the media and no trust in our own community, they're not going to take people are not going to take well to being told to essentially put restrictions on their life. Now, listen, I'm not saying masks are the biggest restriction in the world. I'm saying it is a restriction in some capacity. I personally don't care all that much. But let me tell you something. I saw this next story, and it says to me that people are, well, they have no faith in the system and they're starting to lose it. Check this out. Some 500 coronavirus vaccine doses intentionally destroyed, hospital says. No kidding. A hospital worker, a now former employee at a Wisconsin medical center, intentionally removed 57 vials of COVID vaccine from refrigeration, forcing officials to throw out nearly 500 doses. Now, here's what they say. Initially, they thought it was just an accident. And I'm trying to find out more about this story to figure out what's going on. But they say it turns out it was deliberate. Did this person actually want to destroy 500 doses? Why? Could it be that these people are reading the news and hearing about the side effects and freaking out? Maybe. Could it be that they really hate Donald Trump and Project Warp Speed? Sure. I have no idea why someone would do this. Look, if you want to get the vaccine, your doctor recommends it. I say you follow your doctor's recommendations. I'm not. Look, I know there are side effects. I've mentioned this before. We're inundated by news saying all these bad things. But for the most part, we've now got, I think, like a couple million people have been vaccinated and they're mostly fine. People who follow me and have commented said they got the vaccine, a small percentage, mind you, and that they're fine. I really, really do not think, and maybe it's my normalcy bias, sure, that people are going to get this and it's going to result in some widespread chaos or people turning into zombies or anything like that. But there are people now who are, that's insane. I think it's fair to say Americans are in full revolt against the restrictions, the lockdowns. And it's not just that. Apparently, some people working in health centers are taking issue with vaccines. Look, if somebody wants to get a vaccine, I don't care. Like, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. First, I do have allergies. This is true. And so that people have been advised, if you don't have it, you should wait. So I guess I will. Plus, I'm not in the affected age group. And most of you aren't either. It's not a whole lot to worry about. But I'll tell you, the lockdowns are violating the Constitution. And for this, people are saying enough. And because the media has been just wrong about so much, people are saying, I don't trust you anymore. Reason said, reports, or I should I reports, but in a piece for Reason. Individually and in organized groups, people are pushing back against lockdown orders. Echoing New York Governor Andrew Cuomo, New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio warned city residents this week to prepare for a full shutdown. So this story is a couple weeks old. As part of ongoing efforts to slow the spread of COVID-19, the two elected officials better not hold their breath waiting for compliance. Evidence from around the country shows that many Americans are thoroughly sick of impoverishing, socially isolating lockdown orders, and are revolting against the often hypocritical politicians who issue them. Quote, the governor said in a New York Times interview over the weekend that we should prepare for the possibility of a full shutdown. I agree with that, Mayor de Blasio told interviewers on the 14th. We need to recognize that may be coming, and we've got to get ready for that now because we cannot let this virus keep growing. The mayor commented following Cuomo's ban on indoor dining at New York City restaurants that was issued a week after Staten Island residents cheered bar owner Daniel Presti, who was arrested for defying pandemic restrictions. Days later, Presti ran his car into a sheriff's deputy who sought to rearrest him for continuing to serve patrons. Both of the deputy's legs were broken. Wow, man. I don't know what's going on with that guy. But there was that story. A woman was going to a gas station and a sheriff said, put on a mask, said no, and then started beating the cop. Beating the cop. We had that story where I believe it was the governor of Oregon, Kate Brown, holding a meeting at a state house, and the police barred members of the public from entering. Somebody pepper sprayed the cops. When you've got right-wing groups, conservatives or Trump supporters or whatever, and they're pushing back on the police. Now, you want to tell me that nothing's going on? No, people are starting to get really angry about this. They go on to say the brewery isn't one of the the brewery is only one of many businesses listed by Pennsylvania opening businesses and defying the governor. So this is the Seven Sirens Brewing Company. There's 43,000 members on Facebook. The group encourages the public to patronize anybody who bucks state rules to continue offering goods and services to willing customers. Many readers side with businesses that may stay open in defiance of Pennsylvania's coronavirus shutdown orders. The Reopen Minnesota Coalition similarly represents hundreds of businesses defying closure orders and raises money for legal defense against state enforcement actions. Quote, the last 9 months have needlessly put small business owners and employees in the regrettable position of watching their dreams evaporate before their eyes and their families go without basic necessities. The group commented this week on the effect of pandemic lockdowns. It calls for stripping Governor Tim Walz of his emergency powers and for ignoring restrictions so that people can decide for themselves when and how to interact. On the West Coast, many restaurants also open their doors to customers despite state orders to the contrary. While some of the larger chains and corporations are following the orders, many of the mom and pop shops say going to takeout only would put them out of business. The city council in Solvang, a tourism-fueled community in Santa Barbara County, recently voted to ignore shutdown orders that threaten locals' livelihoods. Officials directed that the city of Solvang will not actively enforce these latest state shutdown orders and that the city request the county and state regulators to prioritize education and that they also not enforce the orders within city limits, according to a letter from Mayor Ryan Toussaint. None of this should be a surprise. Small businesses have taken it in the teeth from restrictions that cut them off from customers and cash. Data gathered by Yelp shows many of them closing permanently. Restaurants, which traditionally have tight profit margins to begin with, have been especially hard hit. Does it make sense to put millions of people in the poorhouse because portions of our society, our culture, our population are vulnerable? No, it doesn't. If we were more surgical with the lockdowns, we could ensure more people are protected. Here's the problem. You come out and say, everybody lockdown. And guess what? A bunch of people say no. Now your plan looks like Swiss cheese covered in holes. What if instead they said, go about your business, but these are the restrictions we have in place, protecting the vulnerable, putting some of the responsibility on, you know, some of those who are vulnerable to stay home and stay safe. But if we focused on those who were most at risk while allowing regular people to work, we'd have better control over what was going on. Instead, what are we getting? California is facing serious repercussions from just all of the mistakes they've made. U.S. braces for super COVID tsunami. Fauci warns 70% more contagious strain, which has brought UK to its knees, will now rip through America as two cases are confirmed in California and Colorado. What have they done to stop this from happening? Nothing. Now, let me tell you, we can't stop it. They told us this. OK, the World Health Organization, the doctors, They said the best we could do is slow this down. So the spread apparently was inevitable. Are we doing enough to protect those who are most vulnerable? I don't think so. If we kept the economy open with social distancing and masks and protected the vulnerable and allocated this the trillions of dollars we're spending on stimulus towards protection measures, maybe screens, maybe testing, maybe treatments, we probably would be better off. I mean, at least in my opinion. Instead, what do we get? Democratic governors across this country shuttered everything, everyone, regardless of whether or not you're in the affected group. Thus, people don't have money and they're forced to print out money like crazy. It's only going to get worse. It's just not solving the problem. Worse still, the young and the healthy are revolting. And that's, I mean, that's the main point. Maskless mob storms gourmet grocery in city awash with death. They're a symptom of a psychic sickness stoked by President Trump. Think about how callous and insane that is. People like this writer for the Daily Beast who says that. He's writing. He's working. Some of these people lost their jobs. They have nothing. They've lost their homes, their businesses. Their families are going hungry. And it's only a matter of time before they kick in the door and just take what they want. It happened in Italy earlier this year. Videos of people storming into grocery stores and small, you know, corner markets and just taking because they had no money anymore. The money ran out. They had no more, you know, no paychecks coming, no jobs, nothing to do, but they still need to eat. Do you think these people who are angry and are tired of the lockdowns will just roll over and slowly waste away? Or are they going to say, we are hungry and we refuse to live under your boot? Desperate times call for desperate measures. And it doesn't matter if it's, you know, I'm not talking about morality, right or wrong. I'm saying these people are losing it because they're desperate. So there's a members only article, but you get the point. I've covered this story quite a bit. But let me tell you what we can expect next. Dr. Fauci warns January could be the deadliest month of the pandemic, as the CDC predicts the death toll will top 400,000 by the time Trump leaves office in 3 weeks. They say Fauci predicted the U.S. crisis will worsen significantly next month. Okay, I think we're not handling this well. I think we're not doing any kind of legitimate protection program or stimulus program or funding program. Instead, we have a hodgepodge mishmash of failed policies and failed politicians who violate their own policies. You have people like Governor Gavin Newsom. He goes out to eat, defying his own policies. How am I supposed to trust that Fauci is saying the right thing when we see him at a baseball game with no mask on? How am I supposed to trust that Cuomo is telling us the truth when he put sick COVID patients in nursing homes, killed 6,500 people? That's ProPublica that reported that. You want me to do the right thing, and I want to. I don't want anybody to lose their lives. But the people who are standing up and pushing back are tired of the hypocrisy. They're saying enough. They're saying no. Because at a certain point, when these people become desperate, you can't control what they do. The best thing we could do now is work with people to make sure that they're being fulfilled, that they have access to the goods they need. Otherwise, then you can do nothing. In New Jersey, we saw these two women open a speakeasy in a warehouse. There was gambling and food and drinks in a warehouse. I'm sure there was a violation of tons of, you know, labor laws and you know, restaurant laws and things like that. But they just did it because at a certain point they say you have no authority. You've pushed us into a corner. We're hungry. We're starving. Screw it. We're going to go out and do it. And then the rule of law breaks down. Now, I get it. Look, Fauci is saying things are going to get really, really bad. You know what my problem is? Fauci also told us 60 to 70% herd immunity, then came out later and said, actually, I was lying. I didn't think you were ready to hear the truth. So then why would I assume this is the truth? They told us earlier in the year. Happy New Year's, by the way. New Year's Eve. They told us earlier in the year we could be expecting millions of people to die. Well, it's hundreds of thousands, and that's still really, really bad. One person is too many. But they attack Trump as though it's worse than it's ever been when the initial prediction was millions. Now Fauci is coming out and saying 400,000. But they have been wrong. Fauci was the one who told us not to wear masks. He was wrong. And now you've got people who won't wear masks. Who do we blame? I blame Fauci. I mean, honestly, I blame a little bit of everybody. There was a period where Trump was not wearing masks and said he wasn't going to wear masks and things like that. But what you need to realize is that with the rise now of these warnings about more deaths and super COVID, the lockdowns are going to get worse. And I can only imagine people are going to erupt. The Daily Mail reports Britain is seeing infections soar as hospitalizations climb to their highest levels on record. London and southeast England were placed under strict lockdown measures earlier this month, and dozens of countries banned flights from the country. France also briefly barred trucks from Britain. The UK on Wednesday recorded its deadliest day since April, with 981 COVID fatalities and 50,000 more cases, as another 20 million people were plunged into the toughest restrictions in a desperate attempt to control the spiraling second wave. Let me tell you what is now going to happen in the UK. Lufthansa will airlift food into the UK amid border closure and fears of food shortages due to new COVID strain. You know, my friends, earlier this year, I was promoting a emergency food supply called safeandreadymeals.com. When I promoted that, people mocked me. Many leftists were like, Tim's so dumb selling his emergency food. Well, I suppose if you were in the UK and you were watching me and you took it seriously and you ordered this food, you're probably eternally grateful now. They've shuttered the borders. They are saying they will need to airlift food to the UK because there's fears of food shortages. What if you ordered a couple of these emergency food supplies? You'd be fine. You'd say, okay, well, I'm better off than my neighbors. I'm not doing a promo. I'm not trying to do a promo or anything like that. I'm just saying, you need to recognize that these lockdowns will likely only get worse. The police in many of these big cities have no problem enforcing draconian edict from these governors. Many of them, I think, are hypocrites. Many of them are responsible for the destruction. Take a look at Florida compared to New York. Florida's got some major cities. Miami is a massive metropolitan center. And Florida's done way better in terms of keeping control of this than New York. That's the problem with the Democrats and their lockdowns. DeSantis is now saying he's not going to lock down. And guess what? There's a spike in cases for sure, but it's nowhere near as bad as California or New York, where the lockdowns they put in place don't work. Now you've got places like the UK. This to me is some of the craziest stuff we've ever seen. They say the German airline will fly 80 metric tons of food to Doncaster, Sheffield in northern England using a Boeing 777 freighter. A spokesman said Tuesday, while the European Union called for the resumption of transport to the UK, the key port of Dover remained snarled with trucks unable to cross the Calais, across to Calais for a second day. Calais is a city in France. It's right on the other side. You take the tunnel, I think it's called. France, which severed the link after a faster spreading strain of COVID-19 emerged in Britain, told the EU the route should reopen by midnight, according to people familiar with the matter. Lufthansa said the emergency flight will carry unspecified perishable goods from Frankfurt, a major European hub for food distribution that has strong connections to producers in Italy, France, and Spain, as well as the Netherlands, where food is grown under glass to extend the growing seasons. The carrier said it's working with multiple freight forwarding specialists, which it declined to name. The head of Britain's Food and Drink Federation, Ian Wright, told Bloomberg TV earlier that if the port crisis wasn't resolved, there could be shortages of foodstuff sourced from outside the UK, such as citrus fruits and some green vegetables. Sainsbury warned Monday that the chaos at Dover could result in gaps on its shelves for items including lettuce, other salad leaves, cauliflowers, and broccoli, as well as fruit. Tesco, Britain's biggest retailer, urged customers not to panic buy, saying it had good levels of stock, including food sourced from France. The British Retail Consortium estimates that around 40% of the food supermarkets import comes through Dover, with a higher proportion of fresh produce. What do you think is going to happen in the UK, if people can't get food? Now, I'll tell you, since this all started, people have gotten really out of shape. I mean, they've not been getting vitamin D. They've been not going in the sun. And that's contributing to a decline in people's health. What happens when people out of shape, sickly, get COVID? I mean, that's going to make things worse. Then the lockdowns in turn will get worse because we get more sickness. Is it possible that because people aren't getting vitamin D, Fauci recommended vitamin D. Fauci said it. Take vitamin D supplements. Don't take too much. Talk to your doctor about what's right for you. But is it possible that people aren't exercising and eating right and getting the vitamins they need, and so they're more susceptible? You see, this is the problem. Florida, tons of sun, not doing all that bad. New York, miserably. California, also tons of sun, doing particularly bad. So how do you compare Florida and California? The lockdowns are not working. Okay, to a certain degree, we can argue, yes, they probably have some positive effect, but they need to be more surgical. Worse still, I don't think it matters. The people in these places are going to snap. And look, you see the people in California storming into Erewhon, it's the name of the grocery store, angry. What about when there's no food left? I remember when the panic buying started, toilet paper was all gone, but more importantly, milk, bread, and eggs, cream cheese, dairy was gone. I went into a Walmart, all of the milk just gone. All they had left was like almond and soy milk. I took the almond milk. Couldn't get yogurt, couldn't get toilet paper. It was crazy. I posted a photo on Instagram. Panic buying is not a good idea. You don't need to rush in and buy everything up because, you know, all that stuff will spoil pretty quickly. But what happens when the supply chains break? Then you rely on food being airlifted into your country, like in the UK. What happens when we're forced to quarantine a certain part of this country, or like they already did, they do these lockdowns, and then food can't be imported or food isn't being produced? Are you taking care of yourself? Have you planned for this? What's your plan for when people flee the cities desperate for supplies and food? What happens when people revolt in these cities because they've been locked down for too long and they're hungry and they can't survive like this? Reason has already said people are in revolt. Nonviolent civil disobedience, I think, is the best way out of this. People just passively resisting, like we've done historically throughout this country. I mean, there's been violent unrest. This country was born with a violent revolution. I get it. But civil disobedience is one of the best and most effective ways to get things done. Just work. Take care of yourself. Otherwise, I fear what comes next. You see, it's kind of like you have this anger being held back, but it's growing every single day. And it's not just going to go away. Eventually, it's going to burst out with so much pressure building up, you know, in this pipe full of anger, whatever. It's flowing out. What if we allow people to just get some of that anger out? What if we allow people to just relieve some of this tension? If we don't, they're going to rampage like they did during the George Floyd riots. I understand super COVID's a problem. I understand California is seeing more death than ever. Maybe you're doing something wrong. And if you don't course correct, people are going to erupt. They're already starting to. You know what, my friends? It's New Year's Eve. I didn't want to do a segment on this. I wanted to do a segment where it's like, we're going to party, we're going to have a good time, and we're going to think about the good times ahead. Sorry if I'm a little pessimistic. I think 2021 will probably improve in some ways, but we're not out of the storm yet. Things, you know, they say it's always darkest before the dawn. Keep that in mind. Take care of yourself. Do what you have to do to survive. Peaceful, nonviolent civil disobedience, standing up for what you believe in, taking care of your family, getting supplies, learning how to be self-sufficient, getting away from these cities, man. You can do that. You can get out of these cities. You have that choice. Not everybody does. I understand. Can cost a lot of money. But you do not want to be in a city like New York or Los Angeles when the food shortages hit. If they do, because I'll tell you, things are probably going to start looking bad in the UK. That's why they're bringing food in. But I'll leave it there. I think we're going to wrap up for the day. I don't think there's going to be a live show tonight. Why? It's New Year's Eve, and you guys should be having a good time. So hang out, watch a movie, put on Lord of the Rings or whatever, and time your movies just right so that on New Year's you get to hear that, you know, key phrase or whatever, however people do that thing. And I will see you in the new year tomorrow at 10 a.m. over at youtube.com/TimCastNews. Thanks for hanging out, and I will see you all then.